Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Hot, humid, and hazy. That's what Granite Staters will be dealing with once again today, as temperatures are expected to reach well into the 90s. The extreme heat is raising concerns among health officials who say anyone who suffers from respiratory problems should take it easy. Some schools are also taking extra precautions. In Litchfield today, school officials are stressing hydration, and they're allowing parents to keep their children with respiratory issues home. In Hudson, school is optional for all students today. You may recall at the beginning of the school year in September, the Hudson School District canceled classes from elementary to high school because of extreme heat. Officials say the hot weather has an impact on students' ability to learn and compose health risks. The simple task of inhaling and exhaling in marginal air quality conditions can trigger an asthma attack. Even if you don't have breathing issues, extreme heat takes a toll on kids, the elderly, and animals particularly. Symptoms of heat exhaustion start as cramps in your muscles and can quickly escalate.
With heat exhaustion, you may feel dizzy, you may feel sick to your stomach. Heat stroke would be the most severe form. That's when your temperature is actually above 104 degrees.
Typically, air quality is best in the morning, which is why experts stress that runners and bikers should strive to work out first thing in the morning. Two Dartmouth College students were seriously hurt after falling off the roof of a frat house in Hanover. Police say a 21-year-old man and a 20-year-old woman fell off the top level of the roof at the Alpha Delta House early yesterday morning. They were taken to Dartmouth Hitchcock for treatment. Police say they suspect alcohol as a factor. A mother was arrested for DWI while picking her child up from school. Hudson police say Christine Eno had her one-year-old with her yesterday when she was picking up another child at Nottingham West School yesterday. After posting bail, she was then taken into custody by Manchester police for a criminal threatening warrant and posted bail again. A home invasion in Concord is under investigation. Police say a man forced his way into an 84-year-old woman's home and robbed her. The woman was not injured in the robbery, but the suspect took off with thousands of dollars in jewelry. It all happened just before 7 o'clock yesterday morning. The man was watching the woman as she did gardening outside her home in the city's South End. When she opened the door to go back inside, he pushed her through the doorway and headed for her jewelry box.
At this stage of the investigation, it appears the subject had to know something about this victim. It appears that he knew the layout of the home, and he obviously knew somewhat of this woman's schedule.
That suspect is described as a white man with a medium build, between 5'8 and 5'10. Police say he ran to a waiting vehicle that was an older model tan or gold sedan. Anyone with information is urged to contact Concord detectives at 225-8600. Residents in one Merrimack neighborhood are on edge after someone vandalized property on several streets over the weekend. Police say they're investigating nearly 20 reports of vandalism. The first call came from a resident who noticed spray paint on cars parked on a street. A house on Carter Road, even had a graphic graffiti sprayed on it. Police say that they are close to catching the person behind this, who they think is a 17-year-old male. If you have any information that may help, call Merrimack Police. And that's it for your morning webcast. We hope you can join us for more news today at noon.